Hi, my dear students. How are you all? I hope you all fine and safe at home. This is M. Tamilvanan, your physics teacher from Bharathidasanar Matric Higher Secondary School, Arakkonam. Today, I am going to introduce some new topics: equipotential surface and electrostatic potential energy from 12th standard physics, first unit, electrostatics. So what is equipotential surface? The equipotential surface is nothing but an equipotential surface is a surface on which all the points are in the same potential. Let us consider, this is one positive charge, Q charge. So here electric field will produce in outward direction. This is a point charge. So this electric field is non-uniform electric field. Yes. Now I draw one circle from the center point. The distance is r. This is a r. What is the potential? The potential is nothing but the small amount of work is done moving a unit positive charge from one point to another point, or from infinity to that point. Yes, that is called electric potential. Here let us consider this is a point A. Now I move one positive charge from A point to and B point. See, A point and B point, the both are in a same distance from the source charge. So here the potential is same. So this surface, in this surface the potential will equal. Okay, if I move from the same charge from this point to or this point, the potential will differ for this two circle, but in this circle the potential will same. That is what equipotential surface. Yes. Now let us see for uniform electric field equipotential surface. See, this is a uniform electric field. In this uniform electric field, let us take three planes. These planes are imaginary plane, but in this plane the potential will be equal. So here the potential I take V1. For the second plate the potential is equal to V2, and for the third plane the potential V3. But the first plate, if you take any point in this plane, the potential will same, will be same. But the potential for second and third, or first and second plates, so will differ. So this potential is a equipotential. Yes, here I take this a V1 and V2, then V3, but here the potential will be same. This is called what? Equipotential. So this potential we can say the plane equipotential surface. Plane equipotential surface. Let us consider one positive charge. From this positive charge the non-uniform electric field will produce the positive charge. So this electric field is a what? Non-uniform electric field. So here we can draw the different circle. So in this different circle we have different potential. But if you take any one circle, so in this circle, so if you take any points on this circle, the potential will same. So this potential is what? Equipotential. So this we can say what? Spherical equipotential surface. Yes. Next, the properties of equipotential surface. The first property, no work is done in moving a test charge. Test charge means the small amount of charge from one point to another on an equipotential surface. If you move one unit positive charge on that equipotential surface from one point to another point, that work is equal to what? Zero. So here the work done is equal to 0, which means the potential difference between VB and VA or the del V is equal to 0, which means the work done by the unit charge is equal to 0. Why? Because both are same potential, VB equal to VA. If you substitute here VB equal to VA, this term will equal to 0. So that is called what? The total work done is equal to 0. Total work done is equal to 0. Where? Yes, on equipotential surface. Right. Next, or second point, the electric field is always perpendicular to the element, the dl of the equipotential surface. See, this is a electric field lines. So in these lines will act perpendicular to that plane. Perpendicular to that plane. Here the angle between plane and the electric field is 90 degree. If you take any shape, so the electric field always act which direction? Perpendicular to the direction. So that's why we can say what? It is always act perpendicular to that element. Okay. So the no work is done on equipotential surface. So we can write the work done is equal to minus the integral from A to B, E vector dot dl vector equal to 0, which means E vector dot dl vector, we can write E into dl cos theta equal to 0. If E equal to 0 or dl equal to 0, the total work done equal to 0. Suppose E is not 0, E is what? Electric field. Electric field not a 0 and a dl is not a 0, that time the cos theta equal to 0. What is this meaning, cos theta equal to 0? Very good. Cos 90 degree equal to 0, so theta is equal to what? 90 degree. So cos 90 degree equal to 0, so the total work done on equipotential surface equal to 0. Right. Next, third point, the equipotential surface indicates the region of strong or the weak electric fields. Strong or weak electric field. So from this point we can say the electric field is defined as the negative gradient potential. Negative gradient potential or negative potential gradient. So both are equal to, E is equal to minus dV by dx or dr. E is a electric field, V is a potential and R is a distance. R is a distance. So we can write the dr is equal to minus dV by E. Okay. Next, since the dV is constant on the equipotential surface, so this equation dr is inversely proportional to E. What is this meaning? If the distance increases from the source charge, the electric field will be decreases. Okay, that's why we have to put what? Negative. So this is the negative gradient potential. So E is a strong, which means what? So dr will be small. Next, the separation of equipotential surface will be smaller. Will be smaller. So and the if the distance is smaller, the electric field will be increases, which means larger. This is indicate what? Equipotential surface. Next, the fourth point, two equipotential surface cannot intersect. This point already we seen in the properties of electric field lines. The two electric field lines is never intersect. Already we seen in last video. So if two equal equipotential surface, if two equipotential surface intersect, then at the points of the intersection there will be two values. There will be two values of the electric potential. Is it possible? No. Yes, it is not a possible. That's why the two equipotential surface is never intersect. Okay, yes. Next, so here the electric potential is a scalar quantity. Electric potential is not a vector quantity, it is a scalar quantity. Why? Because it has only magnitude, there is no direction. But the potential gradient, it is a what quantity? Vector quantity, very important. It is a vector quantity. Okay, so the negative sign of the potential gradient shows that the rate of change of potential with distance is always against the electric field intensity. Electric field intensity. So the E is equal to rate of change of potential with respect to distance is a negative. Okay. Next, electrostatic potential energy. Electrostatic potential energy. So potential energy. Energy is equal to work done. Energy equal to work done. So the small amount of work is done moving a unit positive charge from infinity to one point in against the electric field, that is called what? Electrostatic potential energy. Electrostatic potential energy. W equal to Q into V, where W is the work done, Q is a charge, V is a electric potential. V is a electric potential. Let us see what is the formula for electrostatic potential energy of a two-point charges. This is my system. I take two charge, Q1 and Q2 charge. The distance between the origin for Q1 charge, I take R1, and the distance between O and B is R2. The distance between A and B, this is the first charge and the second charge. So I can write R2 vector minus R1 vector R12 vector. Yes. So what is the formula? The work done is equal to Q into V. See, the work done is equal to this equation. I can write Q2 into V. What is the V formula? V is equal to, we know, V is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R. Or if you take Q1 for first charge, means you can write what? Q1. V is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R or Q1 by R. Here I am taking this V, W is equal to V value 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 by R, and the another charge is Q2. This is a what? Work done. So this work done we can write energy U. Yes. So our equation is U is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 by R2 vector minus R1 vector. This is a modulus. Can take only value, not a direction. Or we can write this equation U is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 by R12. This equation for the potential energy only two point charges. So I can write for three charges. Same like that. So this is my system. Here I have three charges, Q1, Q2 and Q3 charges. The distance between O is R1, and the distance between O and B is R2, and distance between O and C is R3. Now the distance between first charge and the second charge, I can write R12. So this is R12. And the distance between first charge and the third charge, this is what? R31. And the distance between second charge and third charge is R32. Yes, what is the formula for electric potential energy? U equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q1 q2 by r12. So I can write this formula u is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. First I take only two charge, first charge and second charge, so q1 into q2 divided by, so this distance I can write what, r21 or the modulus of r2 vector minus r1 vector. Yes. Next, the distance between q and q3 is r3 and what, r1. So this is the potential between first charge and third charge. So 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q1 q3 divided by r31. Okay, or we can write r3 vector minus r1 vector. Okay, and the electric potential energy between second charge and third charge q2 and q3. So this equation 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q2 q3 divided by r23. Okay, yes. Next, so this we can write 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught the same as it is, q1 q2 by r12 plus q1 q3 by r31 plus q2 q3 by r32. Why? Because here 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught common, we take it outside. Okay, so this equation for the electric potential energy for three charges. Okay, if I take n number of charge, so this equation I can write u is equal to 1 by 2, which means 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught summation I equal to 1 up to n. So summation j equal to 1 up to n. So I is not equal to j. I is not equal to j. So qi and up to qn divided by r j vector minus r I vector. So this is the general formula for n charges, but we can use this equation for three charges. Okay, so mostly we can use only this equation. Okay, so by using this formula we can see one problem. What is this problem? Yeah, read this. Three charges are given, minus 2 into 10 to the power minus 9 coulomb, the second charge plus 3 into 10 to the power minus 9 coulomb, minus 4 into 10 to the power minus 9 coulomb are placed at the vertices of an equatorial triangle ABC. So the three charges are occupied in the corner of a equitriangle. The distance is a 20 centimeter. So all sides are equal. Calculate the work done in a shifting the charge ABC to A1, comma B1 and C1 respectively. So which are the midpoint of the sides of the triangle? So these are, we have to move from corner to center point, from corner to center point in a equal triangle. See, let us consider equal triangle. So here three charges are given. Now I take A, this is B and C. Here the first charge is placed, that is minus 2 into 10 to the power minus 9 coulomb, and second charge Q2 is equal to plus 3 into 10 to the power minus 9 coulomb, and third charge Q3 equal to minus 4 into 10 to the power minus 9 coulomb. What is the distance? 20 centimeter. So here all sides are 20 centimeter. 20 centimeter. What is our question? How much of work is done? These three charges move from corner to at midpoint. Now the first charge I move from here corner to and the center point. So now I take, this is the A1. and this B point, B charge move from here to the center point, I can write B1. This is center point, and the C charge move from here to the center point is a C dash. So this A1 and B1 and C1, this is our midpoint. Okay, so work done. What is the formula for that electric potential energy for the three charge? So general formula, U equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, the first charge and second charge, Q1, Q2, Q1 into Q2 by R, then plus second charge and third charge, Q2, Q3 divided by R. Here R is same, that's why we can write what R. So R, we can write R12, here R31, then plus third charge and first charge. So Q3 into Q1 divided by R31. Okay, so this is our general formula. But we have to find out the initial and then final. So the total work done is equal to what is the final electric potential minus what is the initial potential energy. So the work done is equal to the difference between final potential energy minus initial potential energy. So we have to find out first UF and UI. UF and UI, okay. So UF is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 by R, then plus Q2 Q3 by R, and plus Q1 Q3 by R. Yes, so UF is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. The Q1, Q2, Q3 values are given and the distance also given. So Q1 value minus 2 into 10 to the power minus 9 and Q2 is equal to 3 into 10 to the power minus 9. So 3 2s are minus 6. 3 into minus 2, 6, and 10 to the power minus 9, 10 to the power 9, minus 9. The base are common, that's why the power will be added. So this value minus 6 into 10 to the power minus 18. Next, Q2 and Q3. Q2 and Q3 minus, this one is plus, so plus into minus minus, and 4 3s are 12 into 10 to the power. So your power also minus 9 minus 9, so minus 18. And Q1 and Q3, Q1 and Q3 both are minus, so minus into minus plus, so 4 2s are 8, here also 10 to the power minus 18. The distance is all our same distance, so the distance is given 20 into 10 to the power minus 2. The 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught value we know, 9 into 10 to the power 9, and the distance 20 into 10 to the power minus 2, minus 6 minus 12, how much? Minus 18 and plus 8, so minus 18 plus 8, 10, this is minus 10 into 10 to the power minus 18. So 10 1 times and 20 2 times, the power minus 2 here minus 18, so minus 16. So the value 9 minus 9 divided by 2, so here plus plus into minus minus 4.5, because this is a 4.5 times 2 tables, okay, into 10 to the power here minus 16, here 9. So minus 16, 9, how much? Minus 7 joule. So this is the final potential energy. Final potential energy. Okay. Now we have to find out initial potential energy. So what is different for initial potential energy? The distance is nothing but half of distance will be decreases, half of distance. So initial distance is 20 into 10 to the power minus 2, and half of distance, so we can write R1. So how much? 10 into 10 to the power minus 2. Okay, so UI is equal to, already this values will be same, okay, the distance only different, that's why I can substitute directly 9 into 10 to the power 9 divided by the distance is 10 into 10 to the power minus 2, and this value will same, minus 10 into 10 to the power minus 18. So if we cancel, we will get, so UI is equal to 9 into minus 9 into 10 to the power will be same for both initial and final energy. So UI is equal to minus 9 into 10 to the power minus 7 joule. So what is the formula for work done? So work done is equal to, so work done is equal to W UF minus UI. UF minus UI is equal to UF, how much? Final, minus 9, minus 4.5 into 10 to the power minus 7 joule, and initial minus 9 into 10 to the power minus 7 joule. So minus 4.5 into 10 to the power minus 7. So minus into minus plus 9 into 10 to the power minus 7. So the final answer 4.5 into 10 to the power minus 7 joule. So this is the total amount of work done. Okay. Yes. So we have to see what is the equipotential surface and the potential energy for a 2 charge and 3 charges for n number of charge. The finally, we have to discuss one problem based on the electric potential. Thank you.
நளினி அமிர்தாவோட ஃபாதரை பிகேஜிலேருந்து ஐஸ்லாண்டு படிக்கிறாங்க. இப்போ காலை 5:30 to 6:30 வந்து கிரவுண்ட் ரன்னிங் ப்ராக்டிஸ் பண்ணிவிட்டு பாடி எக்ஸசைஸ் பண்ணிவிட்டு அப்படியே ஸ்கூல் அட்டன் பண்ணிவிட்டு மத்தியானமால மொதல் தெரஸ் அகாடமியிலும் ப்ராக்டிஸ் பண்ணுறாங்க, மெட்ராஸ் எம்இஎம்லும் ப்ராக்டிஸ் பண்ணுறாங்க, நேஷனல் லெவலில் வந்து கோல்டு அடிச்சிருக்காங்க.